Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to connect Spring Boot with local MySQL. So let's get started. So I'm going to use IntelliJ as well as my local MySQL workbench, and I will also show you how to create a table only by using Spring Boot Java code rather than creating it manually. So let's get started now. So first thing what you need to do is you need to just go to your browser and you need to search for Spring Initializer. You'll be getting this first link over here, Spring Initializer. Just click it. And here you need to add the dependencies as well as the name of your project and the versions. So I will go with Gradle Groovy, that is fine. Language is Java, and let me just now change the name as Spring Pro, something like that. You can just give it to everywhere. Yeah, you can just paste it and you can just change it here as well. Yeah, this is totally up to your choice, and Jar is fine and Java 17 works for me. So these are fine now. So we will be using some dependencies over here. So just click on add dependency. And first thing we need to search for Spring Web. Just add it, Spring Web. And I'll click again add dependency. And next one is going to be the Spring Data JPA. So it's going to be Spring Data JPA. Here we will be having. And I will add the MySQL driver as well. MySQL driver. And final one is going to be Lombok. The reason why I'm adding Lombok is because we don't want to like manually create the getters and setters or the constructors. We can just use the annotations present inside Lombok. So these are basically the four dependencies that I'm adding. So this is the entire stuff, all right? So once you are done creating all these, you need to just click on generate. So it will be getting downloaded in a form of a zip file. So here you can see, right, Spring Pro. So now let me just go to my downloads folder. So here you can see it is in a form of a WinRAR zip file. So just right click it and just click on extract files. And just click on OK. So it will be getting extracted over here itself. Yeah, so here you can see this is the file. We'll be having source and main.test. So this is the .java file over here. Yeah. So this is the file. So now let me just open this particular folder as a project in IntelliJ. So for that, just go to IntelliJ IDEA. And after opening IntelliJ IDEA, you need to go to File. I need to go to Open. I need to go to Downloads, and here we will be having the Spring Pro, the Spring project. Okay, just click on that and click on OK, and just click on this window. So at first it will take some time to load, so just be patient. I think it will take some time for indexing as well as the Gradle to build, so just be patient at first. So here you can see it will be showing you updating index and importing Gradle. So Gradle build. So these two processes are really important, and you need to like wait for some time until both the processes are getting completed. So here you can see now all the processes have been now completed and there is no loading or anything like that. So first thing what we need to do is we will be just going to my main Java, and here you can see this is my main application over here. So now we will be making some changes in application.properties. So for that, where you need to go is you need to go to resources, and here you will be having application.properties. Just double click it, and here you will be having the application.properties. So first we will be adding our local URL of our MySQL database. So it's going to be spring.datasource.url equal to jdbc colon mysql colon slash slash localhost colon 3306 slash, and next you need to specify your database name that is going to be present in your MySQL workbench. So I will just name it as new db, and you need to specify colon 3306 because this is not like the random port number, this is the port number where MySQL workbench is running, so be specific to that. So once you're added your database, you need to create this particular database in MySQL workbench, otherwise it will throw you an error. So I will just go to my MySQL workbench and create this particular database new db, and if I just now refresh it over here, I'll be having the database created. So this is fine. And next thing, we need to specify the username and password of your MySQL database. So let me just now copy this thing. So it's going to be spring.datasource.username, and we specify the username, which is root. For me, this may vary from person to person. And again, spring.datasource.password. So you need to specify your password. Let me specify mine. So this is fine. These are some of the credentials that we need to give over here. So after this, we will be using some connections or properties for our connection. So it's going to be spring.jpa.show hyphen SQL equal to true. So this command is basically like used to display the SQL command in our console. So I told you like we will be creating a table at the end. So the creation of that particular table and its SQL command will be displayed at the console. So that's the reason why we are adding this particular property. And next thing are going to be some of the default properties. Okay, it's going to be spring.jpa.generate and hyphen ddl equal to true. Next one is going to be spring.jpa.hibernate.ddl.auto equal to update. And final thing, let me just now copy this and paste it. Dot properties dot hibernate dot dialect equal to org dot, you'll be having hibernate dot dialect dot isql 8 dialect. Okay, so here you have to be careful. M is capital, O is small, SQL or caps 8, D is capital and dialect. I think you have to be like super careful over here, because even if you like make a slightest of mistakes, you'll be getting an error and it will take like so much of time. So this is like the code basically. Like you can just pause the video and take a screenshot of it and type it out and verify it. So just take your time. So once you're done like adding the values in application.properties, next we'll be creating a .java file. So for that, you need to just go to this particular folder, main java and com.springpro, the project name. Just right click over here and go to new and create a java class over here. And let me name it as student. And let me just create a class. So this is the way through which we'll be creating a table over in our database. So as you can see in my like MySQL workbench inside my database, I'm not having any tables. So now we'll be creating a table within this particular database. Yeah, I will just select class, and here you can see student class has been created. So now I will specify the columns of the class. So it's going to be private int id. Yeah, and next one is going to be private mark, and next one is going to be private, what was that, name. Yeah, this is fine, I guess. Okay, we need to specify the data type as well. Private string, this is going to be of type int. So now we will be like annotate using multiple annotations now. So first annotation is going to be at entity, because this is going to be a table. Okay, so for that we will be using an entity as well as table annotation. So entity, and next one is going to be at table, and here we will be specifying the table name that we want to get in our MySQL workbench. So I will just go and type table, and we will have the name, and I will give it as student in caps. This is going to be the table name. And next one, we will be using the data entity, because we don't want to set header and setter everything, getter, setter, constructor. We need to like add that manually, but by using this data annotation from Lombok, it will automatically create us everything. So it saves us time as well as code length. So this is good. You need to use this. And after this, we need to just, it's pretty much straightforward. We'll be using the ID annotation for this. Next one, I will give the column name, column. So I will just add the name as ID, and I will just copy this now and paste it, and paste it here as well. I will just change it as mark, and I will just change it as name over here as well. So this is fine, I guess, now. So after doing all these things, you need to like add the configuration over here, because our run button is currently disabled. So what you can do is you can just click on add configuration. You need to just click on plus, and to click on application, and like you'll be having showing you module not specified. Let me name it as project first. Let me name it as like project, and I will go to no module, and I will just create springpro.main. You need to click on the main thing over here. Just click on it, and it will be automatically like detecting the class. If I just click it, so it will automatically detect the class for us. So just click that and click on OK. Yeah, So here you can see now everything is configured. You need to just add the main dot main over here. I think this will be displayed only if you have like configured proper Java and you have allowed your Gradle to build. So please wait. Okay, if anything is loading, don't cancel it. Allow it to like completely load everything. So just click on apply and click on OK here as well. So after we run this program, we will be basically like having a table within this new DB database, which means that we are successfully connected to our local MySQL workbench. That's what we are trying to do in this video. So if I just now run it, I hope there aren't any errors in this. Yeah, this is fine, I guess. So after some time, if there aren't errors, we will be like getting this particular thing. Spring Boot application has started. So here you can see, right, started application. So which means that there isn't any errors. And like if I just scroll up, so here you can see that particular SQL command has been now executed over here. Okay, this is what I meant by the show over here. All right. So now if I go to my MySQL workbench and if I just now refresh it, so if you, here you can see the table has been now created and student has been now created over here. And I didn't create this manually, it has been automatically created by Spring Boot command. And there aren't any errors over here as well, it's perfectly running fine. And if I do select asterisk from student both, so here you can see ID, mark and name. So these are the columns that I have specified over here in my class. So this is working perfectly fine now. So you can also try it out and like comment it down how it is working and if you're able to connect to your MySQL workbench. So I hope you would have found this video useful. I've also run many other tutorials in Java, CRUD operations by using Node.js, MongoDB and MySQL. I will be also doing CRUD with Spring Boot, MySQL and MongoDB. So do check my playlist of my channel, subscribe and support me. Thanks for watching.